pacing back and forth. Oh, I don't understand why you're standing right here. All your shots have scored. No, scratching at the scars you left on my skin. We fight and we fall, then we rise through it all till we find what we want. Then we lose it all again. Your touch on my skin, pull me close, take me in. Just me, just you, lost in the moment.
Hey gems, so one of the most requested videos is my collection of eyeshadow palettes. I'm gonna have like part 1 through 5. Anyhow, I am going to clean up my area and go through some of the palettes, and this video does skip around a little bit because I do have issues with my camera from time to time, so whatever you do not see in this video will be in part 2, but let me show you some of the collection I have and I hope that you enjoy it.
Good morning, guys. I'm actually going to be going through most of my collection of palettes and everything, because I've got to put a lot of it back in order. And I've been taking a lot out and not doing that. So I have this shelf that is behind and to the left of where I shoot my videos. And there are tons of stuff in here, tons of palettes. And I'm going to be cleaning them as I pull them out for you. Okay, this is a palette I got a very long time ago when it came out, the James Charles palette. And let me see. Here it is here. I've used it. I used it quite a few times when I got it. But I don't really reach for it that much anymore. Course, there's so many new releases, why would I, right? So I'm just gonna clean this off real quick, and I always want to make sure that everything is clean and sanitized, and it's so easy to make a mess. It's crazy. So I'm just wiping this down with a Clorox wipe, and then I'm gonna show you the next palette that I have that's also kind of dirty, which is the Jaclyn Hill Volume 2. I've used it a few times, as you can see. So these are some of the Morphe palettes that I've kept. I've given a lot away, like a lot, because I feel like you shouldn't waste makeup. And it does eventually expire and all of that. So these are the Morphe palettes that I felt like were worth keeping. There are a few shades in this palette right here. The berries over here that were hard to work with. And those were the really ones I only found that were hard to work with. So I hope you're having coffee and chilling with me, because that's what I'm doing right now. I also have my MUA starter kit down here. I have tons of bags, the Ipsy bags. I don't even know what to do with them all. Let's see. Look at this down here. Like, whoa. Right? I don't think I have. Let me see. I can put you. View of what I've got going on down here. I've got the Blue Blood palette. I gave away the Alien palette and a few others, I think. Blue Blood is one of my favorites. Oh my, look how used. But it's gorgeous. You could do a bunch of different looks with that. And they were recently discounted too on Morphe's site. They were like $24, and that's crazy for Jeffree Star products. But okay, so I've also got the Famous Blood Sugar palette, and this one has been used as well. I did notice Fresh Meat, I burned my eye. when I used setting spray with it. Other than that, the palette I love for pink looks or neutral looks. More so the pink than anything. Okay. Let me see. I should be getting rid of boxes. So there are some that are still in boxes. The Urban Decay Stone palette is rather new. And I love this palette. I think I've dipped into most every color except for this one here. But it's gorgeous. And I can't wait to use that again. Okay. Let's see. I got this palette and I tried it because you guys wanted me to. It came in, I think, Boxy or Ipsy or something. I don't know. The Zoeva. But I did not like the colors, how they blended. They didn't work well for me. I mean, the colors are pretty, but the story's a little strange. And it just, they didn't work well for me. So I don't even know what I'm going to do with this palette. I may see if someone wants it. But again, I don't like even giving somebody a product that I don't like. Okay, now we've got this. My wonderful friend Jessica sent me this. This was actually in one of the American Influencer Beauty Awards boxes. This is Sadia Slays, I believe her name was. Where's my glue? There's a really awesome glitter glue in here, and these shades are stunning. Stunning. I love this palette. Oh, here's the glue. This glue is one of the best glitter glues ever. I thought NYX or NYX Cosmetics had a good one. Nope, this one beats it. Hand down, love it. Okay, so let's move this aside. We've got the Nikki Tutorials palette, which you all know that didn't work well for me. That's her Beauty Day collaboration. I love the packaging. This, to me, the color story is just really strange. I mean, you've got some mattes in here, but I would have loved darker mattes. The blue was stunning, and these were very creamy, felt like they were going to kind of fall apart, but overall, I didn't really like it. Which is unfortunate because I really do like Nikki. But I haven't used this color yet, and I may go back into this palette, but I may not because I've reviewed it twice now, and both times I just didn't like it. Even with doing the concealer like you guys suggested, this one I will keep the box for because I don't know what I'm going to do with it. Okay, then we've got the O palette here, which I like, and it's used, but overall, it's a good palette for a makeup artist kit because you've got tons of different shades you can use on different skin tones. But other than that, I haven't touched it since I got it. So, just so many neutral palettes that have come out. And I definitely got fingerprints all over it, so let me clean that up. Then we're getting to one of my favorites. Did I say that? I've got lots of favorites. The Maddie Ziegler palette. Yes, I love this palette. It's small and compact and super cute. I love how the shade names are right there on the cardboard. And as you can see, it's been very well used. I've used every color in this shade. In this palette, and I love it. This, I think, was a $25 palette. I've done several looks with this palette. I love, love, love it. And it's dirty. Okay. Now, let's take a sip of coffee here. I have the Morphe 35C Everyday Chic palette. I don't like the packaging on this. It is actually very cheap. Very, very cheap. I'm cleaning it off here. But I do think the palette is gorgeous. They have the shade names on the paper. Not sure why they go back and forth between that, but look how gorgeous. I think my camera cut off and I didn't realize it. I was showing you guys my Norvina palettes, and this one here, which I'm least likely to, one of the products I'm least likely to use again, because you could do a really good neutral eye look with this, but the other ones I would prefer to have like more blues, more purples, just, you know, that kind of thing. I mean, you can come up with some looks if you want to be creative, but this is not a palette I would give to somebody that's just starting out with makeup. I do hope you guys saw all my Norvina. If not, I'll have to put another clip in here at the end. The Hello Charmer palette, I did not like. I used it once. That's it. One time to do a review. I'm going to put that in my least likely to use again. Okay. Now, I've got the Pur palette. I loved this palette, and I was so surprised because the first festival palette, I'm pretty sure I gave away. This one I created some really nice looks with. So, yes, this one impressed me. I'll definitely try and use it again, considering I have so many. We're going to put her, I guess, down here for now. And then we're going to go in with the Manny MUA. So look at that. I do like this palette a lot. Oh, see, I should come out and use this maybe again. I only used it that one time to do a review. It's gorgeous. Nice fall colors. Definitely. I'm going to have to put that. Oh, my Morphe palette's here. Okay. Now, let's see. What are we getting into? Oh my goodness. Yes, I remember. This one here, the Beauty Crop. I don't believe I liked this one. I think I did a review on it and that was it. These colors here look pretty amazing, so I may have to try this again. Wow, look at that. That's pretty amazing. All right, I'll put this over here with my Pur palette. And we're going to move on to, what do I got here? I've got some Morphe palettes. This one's probably the eyeshadow. Yeah, this one here I used like maybe twice. It's real pretty. It's just not something I reach for very often because there's so many new releases and I'm all about reviewing new releases like crazy. What's shaking in there? Oh, okay. I'm going to put this Morphe palette with the other Morphe palettes. Then we've got the Jeffree Star Cremated. I do love this palette. I used it quite a bit when I first got it. You can create lots of smoky eyes with this, and it just, I don't know. Almost every shadow or pigment, I think this was all shadows, worked very well. Some of them were iridescent, like this one down here, and it just kind of provided a shine with a tint of color. But other than that, I will definitely use this again. That I know. I'm going to put Jeffree over here next to his O palette. Okay, then we've got the crayon box, which I bought a year after it had come out because somebody was raving about it. It was like a $30 palette. The colors in here are pretty amazing, and I do love using them, but I only use them for certain colors. I mean, certain looks. Like if I'm doing a mermaid look or something else, I will reach for this palette. It's definitely worth the value, though. I will say that, and I'm definitely keeping it for sure. I don't really have a place to put her. I'm going to put her back up here on this shelf. Let me see what this is here. Oh, okay. I have not used this in quite some time. Oh, I did use it in the last month. That's right. I used this color. My highlight and contour palette from Morphe. I think this was like a $15 palette. It should be in a different section, though. So we're going to put that over here. All right, my loves, so my camera did not pick up the Norvina collection, so that will be in part
two of my collection, and I do hope that you enjoyed this. Was there something in my collection that you have? Was there something that you want that was in my collection? Let me know all your thoughts and your deets in the comments down below, and thank you so much for taking the time to watch this video. I really do appreciate every single one of you. I love you guys. I'll see you again in part two. Bye.